Tingles with
Lai-Lai. Well, I'm very pleased that you've decided to go with our munch pack mini. This gives you 5 full-size snacks every month. And so these will come by post, and it'll come in a box just like this. We have this beautiful red and white packaging, and you can see it's representative that our snacks come from all across the world. You can see we have Paris, Rio de Janeiro, Egypt, Sydney, New York, just showing how these lovely snacks come from all across the world. I think you'll be very pleased with the first selection that we have here for you in this box. Should be very delicious. So, this has been packed already for us by one of our other employees, and then I'm just here to walk you through it. Basically, normally you'll just receive this in the mail, and this is exactly how it will come. But for this first one, I'm just gonna take you through it just so you get a little bit better idea about what we have and everything like that. Yeah. So let's go ahead and we'll pop it open. This is what your box will look like. It has this cute little interior telling you about our app. You can use a barcode. You can update your favorites inside your app or your account, because you do have the option to customize your pack if there are certain things that you do or do not prefer within your pack. So the important thing to look for in every box that you get from us is this little card here. And this is the card that shows you who has assembled, checked, filled, packed, double-checked, autographed, triple-checked, and sealed. And so that was done by Roxanne. She's a very lovely lady, so should have a good pack here. They're all good, though. And so she's assembled, filled, checked, packed, double-checked, autographed, triple-checked, and sealed this for you. And there you can see she's got her name. This also, on the back, this will change from pack to pack, so you can have a look at it to see if there's a current promotion that you may want to take advantage of. So for example, on this one, you can enter to win 3 months of free munch packs, and you get a classic breadhead, which is one of these. So you can see the 3 boxes. And so that would be the full size rather than this is the mini size, so it's kind of double this size. So what you have to do is take pictures, share on social media, and use the hashtag munchpack of your munchpack. So you can feel free to do that if you would like to enter that with this munchpack. So we'll set the card to the side. So in this munch pack, we have 5 snack items and 1 drink item. Your first snack item is these Tomahawk Chips barbecue potato chips. And you can see first what is very striking about these is this beautiful artwork. So, Tomahawk Chips is a 100% Aboriginal owned and operated company in Canada. So, it is run by a Native American company in Canada, and they are the one that they employed two Aboriginal people in Canada to do the artwork on all of their packs, and they actually went into galleries and looked all around to find what they really wanted. And so these are, you know, beautiful pieces that you would normally see in an art gallery, but you see them here on your chips. Really interesting story, actually, about potato chips. It was actually a Native American who invented potato chips. Yeah, no, it's actually a funny story. Which they actually talk about in the press about tomahawk chips. It's from a different area, because these come from Manitoba area in Canada. Whereas potato chips were actually invented in Saratoga Springs in New York. Well, there was a guest there, and there was the Native American gentleman, was the cook, and one guest kept sending back the fried potatoes, saying that they were too soggy and that they weren't crispy enough. And so, and you know, they tried a couple times, and then finally the cook got annoyed, and he was just like, okay, and he cut them basically like paper thin, and then fried them like that. Yeah, kind of, it was supposed to be a bit of a troll, kind of, you know, to the guests for being so annoying. But the guests loved them, and then that's kind of where they took off from, was just, that was really popular. So, that is part of the history behind these chips. They started in 2015, so it's a relatively new company. And they have three flavors, plain, barbecue, and a ketchup flavor as well. And each have their own individual packaging. It's very beautiful. Yeah, so, and everybody who's come back, they're slightly less oily than traditional potato chips. And they've been very popular just because they're very light, great for snacking on, just, yeah, very munchable. So, I think you'll really enjoy those. And so these ones are from Canada, as we said. I'll just show you the back. The other thing is the part of the reason they started this particular company was for the friendship centers. So throughout Canada, they have friendship centers that do work with the local tribes from those areas, and it's just a place for community and all of that. And so they actually give a discount when selling to these friendship centers for these chips, so it's just a way for them to work together. But this is a completely private venture. Everything was paid for by the, you know, Indigenous people who invested and began the company. So, let's see, no financial assistance. Yeah. It sounds like something political that they kind of worry about up in Canada. So, then the artist, Lloyd Dubois. I wasn't sure, there's two of them. So Lloyd Dubois, he's an Aboriginal man from Canada. And yeah, so he's the one who's done this front artwork. So, next, we have the Mamma Mia, which is a hazelnut wafer with milk chocolate. Yeah, well, the little slogan is that when you put it in your mouth, it'll be so good that it makes you go, Mamma Mia! Yeah. Very delicious. This one is from Poland. So that's where the Mamma Mia comes from. You can see we have three lovely wafer layers and hazelnut flavoring in the wafer, two milk chocolate layers, and then this is dipped and covered in milk chocolate. Yeah, very scrumptious. Very tasty. It's got that crunchiness and sweetness and everything you'd want. Next is the Festi Wow cookies. These come from Colombia, and probably immediately they look a lot like Oreos to you, which isn't far off the mark. They are a chocolate exterior with a lovely deep vanilla cream on the inside. Yes, so they definitely, yeah, kind of pay homage to an Oreo, but a bit different, which you'll see when you try them. But I just love the, what I love, this is actually the Dux, is the brand, D-U-X. But I just love this coloring on the Festi, just so colorful and pretty. Lots of fun. Next is our candy, and I said, yeah, that one comes from Colombia. Next is our Finny Mini Hooplas, the 2-in-1 licorice fun, soft and chewy candies. So Finny is the biggest candy producer in Spain, the most popular candy manufacturer in Spain. So they are very well renowned. Very high quality confectionery. And this is basically like a licorice that's been cut into little pieces and also has an interior, yeah, flavoring as well. So we have orange cherry, strawberry lemonade, blueberry raspberry, and apple watermelon. Yeah, sweet and delicious. Yeah, so Finny was started in the 1970s, and they grew from, you know, just a very small factory floor up to very large size that they have today. Obviously trying to keep all of Spain in candy is a busy business, so yeah, quite a bit to do there. This is the Sante Garlic Almonds. The story behind Sante is very, very interesting. So it was started by a single mom, and she was out of work and kind of like, I don't know what to do. And one of her children said to her, "Mom, why don't you sell those nuts you make? They're so good." So her grandfather had been in the spice trade, and so she had a lot of experience working with spices and roasting nuts, because that was something that she liked to do as a snack for her children. And so she put those two things together and began selling these nuts. And it began just really locally to people around her area. But then eventually she started getting some really big orders, and she got an order for, I think it was like 1,000 pounds of nuts, which was larger than she'd ever had before, so she had to actually hire some people in to be able to help her make the nuts. But she hired people in and was able to oversee it to get the real quality that she still wanted. And that was kind of her first success, and then was able to lease out a commercial kitchen and begin manufacturing on a bit larger scale. So the real philosophy behind Sante is, if you use tasty ingredients, basically take backstage and let those shine through. And they are very meticulous with their roasting process. they're under roasted, you don't quite bring out the flavor. If they're over roasted, they can be a bit, you know, burnt and bitter. And so it's just that beautiful sweet spot, and that's really what they have mastered in these nuts. And then they also have worked to marry them with some very delicious spices. The zip and zing of these garlic almonds, a little hint of sweet, just perfect, goes together in such a lovely way. And so you get a nice little bag of those, great for munching on. So that is all of the foods in your box. The last is a drink. This one is a tea. And this one comes from Bulgaria, which you can see the name here. It's the kind of the side of the box used more at home where it comes from. And then this side is here for us. So we have the BioProgam Fantasy World Hyla tea, and that means pirate. So they have like a pirate tea and a wizard tea. And yeah, they're kind of fun names. And so, kind of the concept is, oh, if you want to be a pirate for a day, well, probably won't be able to, but you can sip this tea and dream about it. So the tea, this one has hibiscus flower, rosehip, blueberry herb, apple, and black currant. And so it just needs about 5 to 6 minutes to steep. And you do have 20 tea bags in there. So plenty of tea in there. And then you've got your lovely snacks. Yeah, so it's just a pretty fun little pack, isn't it? And it's different every time. I mean, that's just an example of these ones. Every time there'll be some delicious snack that's new that you've never had before. But it's always an opportunity to try something a little bit different from all around the world. Yeah, well, because these things have been popular, you know, in different areas. Like, I mean, Visante, obviously they come from the US, but a lot of people from throughout the US may not have heard of them. But in that local area in California, yeah. Oh, and I'm so excited about these tomahawk chips. I just think they're really great. I just love the beautiful artwork on the front. So it's just a great opportunity to really, you know, try different things from around the world. And as I said, you can customize your preferences on the app, so you can get it on the App Store for your iPhone or Google Play if you have an Android, whatever. And these are always hand-packed for you with love and care. There you go. There's your first Munch Pack Mini. If you do want to upgrade the size, you can do that on the app or the website as well. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact us and can help you out. Otherwise, enjoy your first Munch Pack. Thanks for watching this video.